Dear students, today we are going to start our workbook of unit number 2, the fourth page, and the first topic is what is colloquialism. I am going to tell you about colloquialism. The definition is colloquialism is also known as colloquial language and is a form of speaking which uses an informal tone and words. Keep it in your mind to be informal and very casual. It is used in a casual context and is much more easy to listen and to read than more formal context or conversation. I am going to give you some examples of colloquialism, like because we can pronounce it as cause, and going to will be pronounced as gonna. So how are you doing can be pronounced in colloquial language what's up. So family is fam. So here you are having some examples of colloquial language. So look at here, pronoun and verb contraction revision. So the most common form of contraction is the pairing of a subject pronoun with a primary or modal verb. Here given some of the pronouns and verbs that can be easily contracted, like you can see here written we are in a proper form, and in contraction we are going to write it as you can see here. So look at this, we are having they have in a proper form, and below it is given a contraction of it. So this is how you're going to make this table complete with the contractions. Look at this, this is your next topic, close text. You have to fill in the blanks with the suitable words, and the words is given here. What you have to do is to pick a word which suits your sentence and to fill this all paragraph. Now we are going to discuss about interview questions and preparations. When you are going to do someone going to take the interview of someone, how will you put the question in a sequence? So here what you have to do to write the question numbering from 1 to 6 at front of the given questions. You have been given 6 or 7 questions, and what you have to do is just to write what will you ask first, number 1, what are you going to ask second, and the further steps you have to follow. But at the very next page of this page, you have to give the reasons why you put any question at the first or the second. Look at this, now we're going to learn about autobiography. So here you are going to write your autobiography about your early days school experience. Fill in the chart below by writing everything you can remember. Here you have been given a very precise diagram of how you're going to make the sequence of your essay. What kind of things you learned there? First of all, you learned there was cooperation, how to make new friends, and about different subjects. Where was it located? So here you have to give the address. You can define whether it is near to your house or it is far to your house, far from your house. So here one question, how did you overcome struggles and challenges? So in school time you find struggles and challenges, like you are finding difficulty to make new friends, or you find yourself in a difficulty to stay there in the school. So how you come to your feelings at that time, you have to write in this box. And after that, what are you feeling, what were your feeling about the school? Here you have to write whether you like to go to school or not, or what was your experience and feelings. And the next is, what were your teachers like, whether you like your teacher, your teachers were very polite, they were so nice to you, and you can talk them easily. Look at the next. Here you are going to make a character description, character sketch. So the first point you will write here, the character's physical appearance and role in the story. Keep it in your mind, we are going to write about to serve with love, a topic given in your unit number 2, education. So what you have to do is to choose a character, whether the character of a student, whether you're going to write about the character of the teacher. So let us give the physical appearance here, and action, what he or she does. Actions, what type of character he or she is. Now in the fourth, what others say about him. So you're going to write it, what others say about him, and what the traits you observe in the character. Look at this, students. Here you are having descriptive writing. So you're going to write about to describe the thing deeply. So what the place looked like where you lived first. So it was a very peaceful place. It was a very happiest place. And this is an example. Who you might see outside means you here you can write you about your neighbors or about the thing you observe around your house. The wider area means what was immediately around your house means it can be a park, it can be your school, it can be a playland, etc. So this is how you're gonna give a proper description to your paragraph. Look at this, creating LY adverbs. We have already read about adverbs and now we are going to learn how to make LY adverbs. So let us read first the definition. Adverbs which are created from nouns or adjectives modify adjectives or other noun. So first example is modifies verb, like me sings beautifully. Sings is a verb and beautifully is an adverb. So we are creating adverb with LY and modifies adjective. Now we are having an adjective clever and we are writing extremely clever. This is how we are modifying the adjectives. So modifies adverb. This train goes incredibly fast. We are writing about an adverb, but we are creating one more adverb by incredibly. So here some LY words are adjectives when they are not modifying another word, such as friend, or I think choose a noun verb from the listed and create LY adverb to complete your blanks. Dear student, complete your unit number two and make proper notes of it.